pursuit is about striving for more, striving for better, waking up each day with a purpose and taking those actions day after day after day that make you who you want to be. It's not just me. We're all in the pursuit of something. It is what makes life great. I chose bodybuilding as my journey, and I'm loving every second of it. Welcome to the pursuit. What is up, YouTube? Welcome to a new episode of The Pursuit. Hi. We are... Oh, she's just saying.
Hi.
We're both wearing the Gasp flannel shirts.
It wasn't planned.
It wasn't, but we do. Anyway, we're in Lelystad because we are models today. Models. For a new gym opening, so we're gonna do a shoot for them, and then after that train here I'm gonna do legs, and I will let you know how things are going this prep. We are 10 weeks out at the moment. There have been some changes to my training. I've sent updates this morning to Callum, so let's see if he makes any changes today. And yeah, that's it. So I'll take you with me today, so sit back, relax and enjoy. Just arrived here. This is the gym. The camera crew getting ready. It's a pretty nice looking gym. Good lighting for content and stuff. Right now, I'm gonna get my second meal in. Beef and vegetables. No carbs in this meal. We're gonna start shooting and then in about two and a half hours, I'll eat my pre-workout meal, which is good old chicken rice and peanut butter. So getting this in now, and I guess then we'll start. Okay, the shoot is finished. Well, actually, we're still shooting a bit, but we're done. So I'm gonna get my pre-workout meal in now. I brought my scales, peanut butter, and sodium. Gonna get this in and then wait for about an hour, get some other stuff in, my GH, my L-carnitine, and pre-workout, and then we go and hit legs. I have a new training program, which I'll go over the layover in another video, but it's simply just four exercises today for legs. So we got hex squats, barbell split squats, stiff leg deadlifts, and calf raises, four sets of each, except for the stiff leg deadlifts, we have three sets. And been doing that for about 2 weeks now, 6 days a week. Again, I'll go over the full layout in another video, but it's been working very well, so I'm ready. Just get this food in now, and then we're about to start. It's time. Time to fuck up these legs.
Nee, niks vergeten.
Je krijgt echt een mooie pomp van.
Oké, we're a little bit tired from the day, but we got work to do here.
Serious work.
We're gonna start with hex squats. Never did this hex squat in particular. It looks very horizontal, which I don't really like, but we're gonna do it. Just warming up now. Now we got two working sets in the 6 to 10 rep range and two working sets in the 10 to 20 rep range.
10 to 20 reps?
Yeah, that's the same as last week.
I totally forgot about it.
But that also means you could do 10 reps. You don't have to do 20, you just need to go heavy enough.
If I mean, you want to go out, right?
You want to go... I'd probably be closer to 10 and just go heavy. But, okay? That's exercise number one. A lot of knacks.
Yeah.
My knees are crispy.
Are you getting old?
I don't feel them, they don't hurt. They just make sounds.
Yeah, then it doesn't matter.
Let's get it.
My name sound like nails on a chalkboard. Hit you harder than the darts on a dartboard. Damn it, man, I'm creepy like Candyman in a pair of hammer pants with a hammer in his hand. Say what you want, say what you wish, but say my name and it sound like you breaking a dish. Say my name in a whisper like you making a wish. You said my name in the crowd like you afraid I exist. Say my name and it feel like you peeling off a scab that ain't really even healed yet. I don't even fear threats. I don't really feel what they feel when they fear shit. I feel like the pain at a funeral when tears drip. I don't even dodge shots. I dodge bullets like a child playing hopscotch. I dodge bullets like a breakdancer pop locks. I treat your bullets like it's b-ball and block shots.
My tongue is made of razor blades. I think my body's made of steel and flames. It feels like fire when they speak my name. I think I'm
coming from the Thunderdome like Mad Max in a black hat carrying a black cat. They swear they bullets pal, but I feel like they gon' pat pat. We running the same race, but I bet I lap cats. I'm a lab rat. You a lap cat, I'm a rap cat, a trap cat, and I backpack. I eat suckers for breakfast, and you looking like a flapjack. I be doing voodoo, that hoodoo, making them back back. Bringing the past back, I'ma make a flashback. I'ma make them somersault and visuals abstract. You fooling with a spirit that they talk about. Mention me in a room full of people, someone walking out. The bullet dodger, the gun ducker. Say what you want, you dumb fucker. If you want trouble, mention me, please. One verse will make your lungs burst, you're physically bleed.
My tongue is made of razor blades. I think my body's made of steel and flames.
Okay, second exercise. So we just did 4 sets on the hack squats. Now we're doing split squats, barbell split squats. This will obviously work the quads, but also a bit more glutes, because we do a slight lean forward. Slight. Again, 4 sets here, 2 sets, 6 to 10, 2 sets, 10 to 20. I was gonna do stiff legs, but there is no good place to do stiff legs here, because I can't go low enough. And I don't want to pick them up from the floor. So that's the whole reason why I'm doing deadlifts from a rack. Because when I pull from the floor, it fucks up my central nervous system. And it doesn't really do a whole lot more for hypertrophy. So I'd rather pull from a rack and then go straight into the eccentric. Almost touching the floor and go back up. But the racks here are not equipped for it. So I'm going to do seated leg curls instead after this. First, now this one.
My name sound like nails on a chalkboard. Hit you harder than the darts on a dartboard. Damn it, man, I'm creepy like Candyman in a pair of hammer pants with a hammer in his hand. Say what you want, say what you wish, but say my name and it sound like you breaking a dish. Say my name in a whisper like you making a wish. You said my name in the crowd like you afraid I exist. Say my name and it feel like you peeling off a scab that ain't really even healed yet. I don't even fear threats. I don't really feel what they feel when they fear shit. I feel like the pain at a funeral when tears drip.
Between left and right, take a little break, because otherwise the cardiovascular system isn't gonna hold up.
I dodge bullets like a child playing hopscotch. I dodge bullets like a breakdancer pop locks. I treat your bullets like it's b-ball and block shots.
My tongue is made of razor blades. I think my body's made of steel and flames. It feels like fire when they speak my name.
Oh, sweaty.
Yeah, so as you can see, we've been working pretty hard already, and that's just from 2 exercises now. 8 sets each though, or sorry, 4 sets each, so 8 sets in total, even though my brain is fucked up. Now we're going into the seated leg curls, leg curls. We got 3 sets here, 1 of 6 to 10, 2 of 15 to 20. So I'm gonna do my first one.
Coming from the Thunderdome like Mad Max in a black hat carrying a black cat. They swear they bullets pal, but I feel like they go pat pat. We running the same race, but I bet I lap cats. I'm a lab rat. You a lap cat, I'm a rap cat, a trap cat, and I backpack. I eat suckers for breakfast and you looking like a flapjack. I be doing voodoo, that voodoo making them back back. Bringing the past back, I'ma make a flashback. I'ma make them somersault and visuals abstract. You fooling with a spirit that they talk about. Mention me in a room full of people, someone walking out. The bullet dodger, the gun ducker. Say what you want, you dumb fucker. If you want trouble, mention me please. One verse will make your lungs burst, you physically bleed.
I actually really like this particular seed electro. Has a good range of motion and resistance throughout that range of motion. It's really important with things like seed electro, because the strength of this machine is that you can train your leg in terms of knee flexion from a lengthened position. Why is it lengthened? Because you're seated, so you're in hip flexion like you would be in a stiff leg deadlift. And from that position where everything here is lengthened, you curl. Versus, for example, a lying leg curl, where instead of seated, now you have your hips straight or extended because you're lying and then you're curling. You train the hamstrings through knee flexion in a shortened position, but this one from a lengthened position. So it's important that you can actually reach that lengthened position within the machine, and there's tension there. And a lot of leg curls fail there, but this one is very good.
Out in Boca Raton, gangers be stroking your mom. She just broke up with Sean, now giving dope in the thong. We just be cloaking the lawn, bit what you're focusing on. The lows on the bomb, bronze, blonde, posting the guam. Kissing your freak, have you straight kissing your teeth. Do six in the week, shows in the chicks in the sheets. Fixing too frisking the meat, missing the piss on the seat. Fixing up dishes and treats, ripping Simmons and Leech. Yeet, lest we forget what I think with the gut. Smoke cigarette butt, she willing the cut. In the opium den, with the lowliest men. She said, "Cloak me, my friend. Let's do it again."
I think my body's made of steel and flames. It feels like fire when they speak my name.
Okay, finished the training. We're both completely fucked. So it's time for my post-workout snack, which is also called, normally, meal 3, now it is meal 4. So I have two more meals to go after this. It's currently, what's the time? 5:15. So my next meal will be in about an hour time, 6:15, and then my last meal will be around 9. So what we got here is gonna have 5 Snacker Jacks caramel flavor for carbs, and then we have some protein. This is a iced coffee flavor. She's having some chicken and rice. And then we'll be heading back. And I'll give you a little update on how prep is going. Falls good, you've seen my shape now. So I'm gonna dig in. All right, we're back. It's a little bit later, it's 7:00. Because I decided once we arrived just to get the rest of my steps done for the day, which I've done now, so I hit 12K. I do my steps. I don't count the steps that I do during my training. I don't count the steps that I do during my cardio. So it's only the steps outside of my training session and cardio. So total step count will be higher. But yeah, I've hit 12K. Got two more meals at 7:00 now, so I have this one now, and then around 9:30, I'll have my last meal. What we have here is chicken rice and vegetables with some Jamaican jerk spices. And after this, I'm gonna prep my syringes for the week. Important stuff. Callum just replied to my updates. He's very happy with the current shape, which is good. Look at that bicep split. Damn, son. I totally lost my train of thought there. I was so impressed by my own biceps, oh my god.
Callum, what?
So curious as to what updates he will send me. I do think that this week we're gonna push things a little bit harder, either in terms of more cardio or less food. but I'm down for it because I want to get shredded as fuck. So I'll eat this, prep my syringes, give you guys a quick update on where we're standing and where we're going, and then yeah, that'll be it. So see you in a bit.
Okay, I actually just got word back from Callum. He is very happy with the look today. Big shift in my total physique. So there's actually not going to be any changes in terms of cardio or diet. The only thing we're going to do is bump up lipolytics, add in another 20 micrograms of clenbuterol and 5 milligrams of yohimbine. And then I gotta send updates again on Wednesday. So yeah, pretty happy with that. Overall good feedback. Feeling like I'm back in the groove of things and my body is finally playing ball now. It's been like three weeks now that I've been in prep since coming back from Miami, and over since last competition, which was May, I've been through a whirlwind of things with my body, and the way it responded, obviously because of the sleep apnea and all the other stuff that was going on, which kind of made my body like not responsive to anything and just get worse in terms of the look. I've done blood work, everything was fine. Kidneys, liver, lipids, hormones, thyroid. I'm on support, but the support is good. So all of that is checked. And it's only this week now that I feel and can see that my body's responding. As in, I'm getting better pumps again. My body composition is changing for the better. And that doesn't mean just that I'm losing fat now, that's one thing, but I'm also gaining strength again and getting a little bit fuller, and the pop to my physique kind of is back now where it was, yeah, pretty much gone in my opinion for maybe the past month. So I'm really happy with that. Kind of gets like builds up momentum now within this prep, which is the most powerful thing. Momentum, if you're in it, stay in it and you will get great results. So a couple of things to do not to fuck up the momentum is not cheat on the diet, not get injured. Those are maybe the two main things, and just stay ticking the boxes of your daily goals and daily tasks, which I feel like I'm in a really good groove now, and like I said, my body's responding accordingly, so that only leads to good things. So yeah, that's the current situation. Obviously you have seen my little bit of a shape update in this video, which is the 10 weeks out look, which I'm pretty happy with at 112 kilos. That's a solid 112 kilos in my opinion. Like when I was 112 kilos in my last prep, I didn't look as lean as I am now, so there's definitely some progress made there, which is exciting because that means that even though these two preps are pretty close to each other, I will be showing some progress in terms of musculature as well for my coming show, as long as I hold on to it, obviously. But the main goal for us now is coming harder and sharper than we did last time, because that was the main critic last time. So at the like last prep, I was very concerned with preserving mass, because I just wanted to show that I gained mass compared to my show before that, which was a good thing because obviously I did, and I still placed very well both in the regional show and in the pro qualifier. Obviously I won that, but now I am less concerned, as in I know I can hold on to that mass, I just know what I need to do for that, but I want to press the conditioning card a little bit more. So in this case, I'm stepping on the gas pedal when it comes to that, and I just let Callum be the judge when we have to pull back or refeed and things run too flat, or that is something that I'm changing this prep compared to the last prep. So yeah, overall pretty positive at the moment, and I'm gonna try to stay that way. Obviously it's prep, so you know it's always a roller coaster, so there'll be better days, there'll be, you know, less good days, there'll be better weeks, etc., etc. But as long as we focus on what we need to do today in order to be better tomorrow, that is all we can do, because it's easy to start thinking I'm 10 weeks out, I'm 9 weeks out, I'm 8 weeks out, and you're constantly thinking about that show, which is 10, 9, 8 weeks away, whereas you should be focused on today, because that's all you can control. You cannot control yet what's going to happen next week, or what's going to happen at the show. You can only control what you are currently doing in this very moment, as in, you know, sticking to your diet, not eating anything extra, doing your steps, doing your cardio, doing your training all to the best of your ability. And if you just do that day in, day out, then eventually it will show. And the thing was, for the past three weeks I've been doing that, but it wasn't showing, and so I got a little bit frustrated, but I stuck with it, and finally my body latched on to that process, and starting to see things now, which makes me happy. So that is a little bit of an update. Going into 9 weeks out now, obviously my diet hasn't changed, so if you want to see what my diet looks like, just go watch my previous video. Training has changed. You've seen a little bit of it today, but I'll go over the full split in a different video. The leg day today was hit hard, because when I got home I said like I was going to do a large round of steps, which I did, and within that round of steps my VMO, which is my vastus medialis oblique, which is the teardrop quad, cramped up 3 times, which made my whole quad basically fail, and I stumbled 3 times because of that. Just my legs just didn't want to work anymore. 3 times during my round. I looked like a total idiot, but the legs have been busted. So right now, with steps done, cardio done, it's gonna be feet up and chill for the rest of the evening. And tomorrow, wake up and do it all again, except tomorrow is chest day. But yeah, overall excited to get closer to a show again, and doing what I love to do, which is bodybuilding. And this is starting to become a very long conversation with the camera, so I'm gonna stop it right here. I want to thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to comment, like, subscribe, share it with a friend, and I'll be forever grateful, and I will be seeing you for the next vlog, when we will be 9 weeks out, which in that one I will go over my current training split, because then I've been on that training split for 3 weeks, and I can honestly give you feedback on how it feels, what's doing to my body, etc., etc. So all that good stuff still coming. For now, have a nice one. See you later. Peace. Bye. I chose bodybuilding as my journey, and I'm loving every second of it. Welcome to the pursuit.